Hey folks,
Kilt-Man here.
Kilt-Man, at your service. And what kilt is he wearing today?
Well, let's have a look, shall we?
It's blue and it's a Mackay. It's a blue Mackay. How you all doing? Hope you're doing very well. I have just done a day's work. Yes. I shut the laptop down. What a great feeling. And it's a Friday as well. Known as Poets Day. Poets as in piss off early, tomorrow is Saturday. Whee! And that used to mean something, you know, when you could be out all night in the pubs and clubs and like really just go to town. Speaking of going to town, what do you know? I work in town. I work in Liverpool. Although I haven't been for the last, well, 4 or 5 months because of this lockdown shenanigans. But today, oh yes, today, Bojo, yes, Prime Minister Boris Johnson has said that the English people must go back to work, must put more money into the economy, use public transport if you've got no other option, and you don't stay at home to work. Now go back to work, go back to the shops, go back to the office. Oh, shit. Anyway, it is not all doom and gloom, because for one thing, I've got one of these. Another thing, I've got John Debney's awesome score to the classic monster movie Relic playing as accompaniment for us. And something else. You know him. You love him. A good friend of our channel. A good friend of mine. Steve 007 Smith has been up to his old tricks again. You know what he's like. Keeps sending little mystery gifts to the Kilt-Mansion. And we got one today. What is it? I don't know. I genuinely don't know. We've had this relationship where I've tried to guess what it is. In the past, he has foolishly dropped a few little crumbs of clues and I've worked it out. The best one being, you know, the Wolfman cane from the original Wolfman movie. And I kind of sussed it. Oh, couldn't wait. Oh, awesome stuff. Oh, by the way, I do take that out when I go to pub. I do walk the streets with my silver wolf-headed cane. Brilliant, especially when it's a full moon out. But because he felt so kind of like, look, Mrs. Kilt-Man's getting left out, he sends a double package to Mrs. Kilt-Man last time. I did a video on it, the two of us, me, and a rare appearance by my wife. I've now got the camera replaced, so we're okay. And it was spongy stuff. We couldn't work out what it was. We opened it. And they were great big, massive poster-sized, well, huge big poster-sized fabric throws for her favourite band, Squeeze. Squeeze, which she's been in love with the lead singer, Glenn Tilbrook, for, well, as long as I've known her, put it that way. And now, cheers, Steve, there's one of these, because there's two, is now adorning the bedroom wall. So now, I'm not only sleeping with her, she's not facing me, she's looking the other way, looking and drooling at Glenn. Glenn in his younger years, though, the picture is. But anyway, getting back to the status quo. Squeeze, status quo. How many more bands can I fit into this? Something arrived today. And it's from the same company as well, Steve. Redbubble. And it feels spongy. So is it? Is it another throw? Is it another one of these big fabric wall coverings? Well, I don't know. We're gonna find out though. First, I'm gonna have one of these. And by the way, Steve, cheers, my friend, cheers. I do love this. Well, that went down the wrong way then. You know, for a seasoned, you know, firewater drinker, that was a real bad gaff there. That burnt, doesn't normally burn. God, what pipe did that go down? I love, obviously, you know, you haven't got to send anything, but it is wonderful to receive stuff. And it's also, I love the mystery of it. And like, you know, I'm always trying to play the music of stuff, you know, that's relevant. So I've got no idea what this is. And it'd be great to have the music there to play it, but obviously, until I find out what it is, we're just shooting in the dark. I'm not looking. Well, it does feel very, very soft. Very plush. Velvety. I'm going along with another wall covering. What would it be? I'm not looking, folks. I'm not looking just yet. I looked. But all I saw was that. Sort of satin black. That is really lovely. You know, you could curl up with that. As indeed Mrs. Kilt-Man does do with the other squeeze throw. This is good because I don't know what it is. What is that? Blue, black, red. What? I know what that is. I know whose eyeball that is. And it's upside down. I'll give you that.
Oh my God, look at this.
Sweet. Well, you will look at it in a minute.
Oh God.
I need to stand up to unveil this. And I've said that a few times before.
Look at that! Oh wow, look at that! Oh great, look at that! Can you see that? They're getting the blood dripping off his jaws. Tightened down there. Oh my God!
You know what's going to happen now, don't you?
Squeeze is coming down! And the big wolf is going up! Oh shit, hang on. Yes, of course. Hang on, folks. I can do this. Is it this?
Elmer Bernstein score to American Werewolf in London.
Oh, that is a great image, that. Look at it. Look at them blazing eyeballs. That is terrific stuff, that. Oh, Steve, cheers, mate. Look at that. That's a beaut.
No, I didn't guess it. You and me shared a passion for anything wolfish. And, you know, I was thinking, is it some kind of werewolfy wolfman thing? But, you know, the only thing I could think of, but I did not expect a great big.
Oh, there they are. There's Jack and David down there. I didn't see them.
Stick to the road. Keep clear of the moors. Beware the moon, boys. You know what, because I knew I was doing unboxing here, and normally I've got a mask or two around, and I genuinely stood at the bottom of the stairs there and thought, because there's a mask in every room, but I thought, oh, what mask, haven't I brought down for a bit, and normally I'd sit it there, or whatever it was going to be filming, and I did think, what's going to bring down, oh, I've got all the American Werewolf masks as well. That is tremendous. How vivid is that? Take a bit closer look. There's almost a 3D element to that. What I don't think you can see, possibly on this, point of picking it up, is it the actual print looks, although it's so vivid, bold and colourful, really in your face. It does look like sort of, it's kind of like worn, like there's almost a few little, you know, faded bits and tears in it, which looks great. It only just adds to it. Oh, sorry. You know, I've got that bloody mask as well. Could have had him sat there. That is absolutely amazing. And I didn't know it existed. You've got the little hamlet down here. The little superstitious, doomed hamlet there of East Proctor. Can you see? Can you see the church there? There's something wrong here. That much I can tell.
It's him! The one who survived! He's the one. He'll change. He'll kill other people.
And that's the great David Schofield who plays him. I always think it's a bit weird how in the opening sequences where the two Americans, Jack and David, go to the slaughtered lamb, and I could have even worn the t-shirt as well. Oh God, you know. I could have filmed this in the bar, Kilty's Tavern, because I've got the dartboard there and I've got the slaughtered lamb sign. Duh! Steve, you got me this time, boy. But where they're in the pub, I'm like, what's that stone on the wall for?
You made me miss. I've never missed that boat before.
He comes across as a bit more surly, a bit more intimidating. And yet, when Dr. Hirsch goes there, played by the great John Woodvine, when he goes there to, you know, ask about werewolves, sir. Werewolves, that's Brian Glover, Tetley T Man. Werewolves.
It's werewolves, come on, Brian, get it right.
In that sequence, I'll just go and check on the lambs or the dogs or whatever he's going to check on. And they're absolutely pissing down a storm. And like Dr. Hirsch realises he's outstayed his welcome there. You know, he's only bought a little half a glass of Guinness and he's had like two sips out of it and that's it. Right, it's a long way back to London. Fucking hell, you've just spent hours driving there, now you're gonna go straight back. But he meets David Schofield, you made me miss, outside. And he comes across as an absolutely terrified man, very sort of browbeaten, really, this guy, he's on the edge of a nervous breakdown. All of a sudden, that sort of rocky animosity he had towards strangers has evaporated. He now knows, shit, you know, it's now left our sleepy little village. And now the whole world could know. Should the world know our business? Sort of Brian Glover quote there.
It's murder then. Then murder it is. We didn't bring him here. Nobody wanted him here. It's in God's hands now. Oh. Did you hear that?
And Brian Glover goes, I heard nothing. And then he goes, oh, again. And he should say, I didn't hear that either. Ah, folks, you know, it's been a shit old week. Work-wise, it's been crap, and this has been my office. This little segment here of Kilt-Mansion has been my office. Thankfully, I've had music blasting out all the time, but I've been working away there, nipping off occasionally to Kilty's Tavern for a bit of liquid refreshments, of course. But I've also bought nothing because, as Mrs. Kilt-Man rightly informed me, your skins stop buying things. So I thought, postman bin, packages, bump, bump, bump on the door. And these days, the postman won't give it to you. He puts it on the doorstep and then he fucking legs it. And I'm like, package, what is it? And there's been nothing coming until today.
Oh, look at that.
That is going up. That might go. In fact, that's going to go up immediately. So, possibly the next video you see. And the thing is, Steve already sent me an original Alex Ross canvas box art print from the original Wolfman. A stylized view of the climactic scene with the wolf-headed cane about to strike him on the hairy noggin. And that's up there in the front room as well. Kilty's Tavern, it's just on the side you never get to see. This is going to be on the side which you do see. So, bit by bit, Steve, you're redecorating my house. What kind of plan is this? Are you moving in, sir? The way to my heart. It's through werewolves, transformations, and lycanthropy. And you'll win Kilt-Man over every time. Oh my God. That is absolutely amazing. It's bloody frightening too, and I love that creature, but you know, it's still, oh Christ. Just thought as well, the wall it's gonna go on, the bay windows, you know, and when I'm sitting at the bar and people are going down that rocky lane past Kilt-Mansion, that rocky dual carriageway, they can see in, well possibly see in, you'll know that's Kilt-Mansion there. That's where he lives. Who? You know, the one with the skirt on. Or that one, yeah. I've seen him going past doing it. But they can see with the lights at the bar and all that, like sitting there, and there's usually a mask on it as well. That's gonna be emblazoned on the far wall. It's gonna look amazing. Steve, mate, I can't say enough, can I? You know, great big thanks, great big cheers. Everyone needs a Steve 007 in their life. You can't have mine. It's mine, okay? But folks, look at that. Okay, let's just see who's made this, because there should be some kind of label, you know, because you guys might want this. Can't quite see, doesn't it's just a wash label. But obviously, you know, if you guys want this, or no, I presume there's a lot more different types from other movies. Redbubble, oh yeah, that's the same thing, I've gone all the way around. Redbubble also do some amazing t-shirts, and I have a whole load of Snake Plissken and MacReady from The Thing t-shirts and all this stuff as well. On a little side note, you all know how much Snake Plissken is my absolute favourite hero, and I have the full rig out, the full authentic jacket, the proper pants, proper colour pants, the life clock, the tracer, the gun, the throwing stars, the radio, the belt, the eye patch, the hair, you know, the tourniquet to go around where the crossbow bolt goes into his leg. What else have I got? Got everything. The boots, of course, and the shin pads. Got everything. But for many, many decades now, fans have wanted those Snake Plissken pants. Oh, of course, I've got the muscle tee, the wet look, liquid vinyl, zippered muscle tee, muscle vest. But people want the kecks, and they try and make their own and all this. Well, Redbubble do leggings in a variety of different colours, but the same camouflage pattern, and they do the originals. And because what he wears in the movie, Kurt Russell, they are a kind of, well, almost, you know, lycra spandex, because it's bloody tight what he wears. Now, I got my pants made by a guy called Tom McLeod in Tokyo, Japan, you mean? Yes, Tokyo, Japan. McLeod? Yep. Doesn't do them anymore, and they were screen accurate, absolutely perfect, and I love them to bits. I've worn them to cosplay and Comic Con many, many times, but he doesn't do them anymore. In fact, I don't even know if the guy exists anymore, but people are trying to make their own, and I've seen some really dire versions of these, but Redbubble now do, so you Snake Plissken fans out there, they do these leggings. Or jeggings, you might want to call them, because they are ultra tight, very spray on. But, and there is a but here, they're not authentic. Well, obviously not, but they're missing two vital ingredients. The pockets that sit on the front of his thighs, the two big bellows pockets. Without them, you know, it may, oh, that great camouflage, that, but you haven't got the pockets, you'd not. If they did them with the pockets on as well, I would be clamouring to get these things. To be honest, I'll probably get them anyway. But there's variations, and the models they use wearing them are ladies. And boy, they look good in those leggings. A fella is going to look a bit silly. But, you know, with the big boots on, an eye patch, some muscles and a sleeveless top on, you know, who's gonna skit you? But anyway, Bit of a tangent there. Let's get back to the big guy. This queue now is the Elmer Bernstein's unused transformation queue. It's called Metamorphosis, and it's meant to play over David's big, you know, transformation, the Oscar winning for Rick Baker, big effect sequence in a bright lit room, fully naked human being turns into a huge hairy hellhound, and all before your very eyes. But of course, in the finished version, it's one of the many variations on Blue Moon that you hear playing. This is what Elmer Bernstein, the great Elmer Bernstein, wrote and composed for that sequence. You can play it alongside it. I think on YouTube, someone's done it as well, and it fits. But because you've grown up with the other version, the kind of absurdity of Blue Moon, and then this horrible transformation taking place, it's like, what the hell? With the scary music playing, it kind of fits it, and it kind of dilutes it as well. So I get why John Landis did use that alternative musical track instead, the song instead of the spooky music, which is great, but it takes that. American Werewolf is one of the perfect horror comedies. The comedy is hilarious. The horror is horrific and scary, and it works on both diverse, you know, angles. But this music may have tipped it over the edge. My opinion, you know, but because the rest of his score plays in subtle, melancholic little motifs and little harmonies for East Proctor and for the tragedy of, because it is a tragic story. The Wolfman story, in essence, always is. An innocent victim becomes a howling, bloodthirsty monster, kills the people it loves, doesn't want to hurt anyone, and then in the end, someone that loves them is going to have to go and kill them to put them out of this horrible, nightmarish misery. Personally speaking, I'd be like, fuck that, I'm staying as a werewolf. You ain't coming near me with that wolf-headed cane. One of them silver bullets. Isn't that great? So, any prizes for guessing what film I'm going to watch tonight? By the way, folks, a great big thank you and big hello to the numerous new subscribers who've arrived. Absolutely wonderful. I am still perpetually stunned that anyone could be arsed watching this idiot spouting, you know, whatever about all and sundry, mainly movies. But great hello and, you know, thanks. Please stick around, stay on board, check back the hundreds of videos there. Got a lot to catch up on, and stick around because there's plenty more to come. And there may be something tonight, but it's Friday and I really want to go out, probably draped with this around me. Imagine that. But there is another classic, and it's a horror, which is coming next. So you might see that tonight, or probably tomorrow morning. Who knows? But folks, in the meantime, and indeed the in-between time, keep it kilted, keep it Celtic, stay hairy, watch out for guys with silver, you know, never trust them. And Steve, once again, mate, thanks so much. Look at that. It's just like that. It's the thing of nightmares, but it's also, to me, it's just a work of art, and I'll just be lying there just staring at that. Amazing. Cheers. So folks, please be happy, be safe out there, stick to the road, keep clear of the moors, beware the moon. There's no food here. Folks, please take it easy, and I'm going to see you all. Threatened by a walking meatloaf!
to ruin you. I've got to take it down and turn the off button. Damn it. I really need to employ someone to stand behind, well, beside the camera, and then on a certain cue like that, they just go, hit that button.